I need advice regarding carrier furnace heat exchanger problems.
There was a furnace lawsuit back in 2007 or 2008 due to the bad design of the exhaust so that moisture drained back into the furnace. Then the furnaces rusted from the inside out.
My furnace was installed well after that time frame.
The settlement of that class action lawsuit was a lifetime warranty. Do you have an extended warranty for this furnace, regardless of age?
No, I don't have an extended warranty.
Really oversized heat exchangers are likely to fail prematurely.
It is more likely the furnace is undersized.
Or you have leaking ducts that let all the hot air escape.
If that were the case, I'd have similar problems with the AC not being able to cool down the house, and that's not a problem for us.
There have been cases where gaskets let smoke into the house, and the repairman suggested replacing the heat exchanger instead of the gaskets.
No, haven't seen smoke in the house. I'm more concerned about carbon monoxide.
A cracked heat exchanger isn't going to cause carbon monoxide that leaks into the home, because of how the hot air flows through the house.
What would cause carbon monoxide buildup?
Blocked or broken flues, open return air ducts by the furnace, insufficient air for combustion and open return air panning are far bigger culprits.
But it is only the heat exchanger I'm concerned about.
A lack of proper airflow can kill your heat exchanger, which is why you want to change the filters often.
And here I only thought about the air moving motors.
Lack of airflow can cause the heat exchanger to overheat, making it more likely to fail, or simply shut off due to being too hot.
Then I really need to check the air filters.
Check for cracks, because any crack is a reason to replace the heat exchanger, if not the whole furnace. And when it is running, look for light that you can see through the heat exchanger, because that's an indication of hidden cracks.
That's harder to do on the secondary heat exchanger.
If you remove the blower motor to see the secondary heat exchanger and see marks above or on that blower assembly, then it is likely the secondary heat exchanger that has failed.
I don't think I could do that without upping the future repair bill.
The heat exchanger is designed to last the life of the unit, 10 to 20 years. The sheer cost of replacing it usually leads people to replace the whole furnace instead.
I guess that's why some people can get away with saying replace the whole thing instead of the gaskets when it is leaking fumes. Is relying on leaking water a good verification of the problem?
Only if the leak isn't due to a clogged drain line or condensate escaping through various joints and intersections on the furnace. So you think it is a heat exchanger problem when it is really drainage or combustion problems.
I guess that's why they say that everyone needs an annual visual inspection of the furnace.
That won't catch all cracks, but thermal imaging can see the cracks that might otherwise be hidden, like round ones around where pipes meet the heat exchanger.